Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, we humble ourselves before you, giving your name the praise, the glory, the honor, and the thanks for every single thing that you have done in our life. We thank you for what you have done, for what you're doing right now, and for what you're getting ready to do in the lives of your people. Heavenly Father, we bow ourselves before you, God, humbly yet boldly before your throne. Father God, we say have your way today in this service. Use whom you will in the way you have them to be used. Heavenly Father, let your Holy Spirit take control today, God. Move supernaturally in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus, God. Father God, if there's any sick among us, God, Father, we say that you be our Jehovah Rapha today, God. Father God, if there's any, God, that are lonely today, God, that you will be their company keeper, that you will be their shalom, God, that you will be their peace, God, in the name of Jesus, God, we ask that you right now, God, in the name of Jesus, God, Father, sweep through this place, God, be our everything today, God. Some came in for one thing, some came in for another, God. You are the God, God, that can speak one word and answer every different request at the same time. Be that God today, God, in the mighty name of your Son, Jesus. Take control, God. Let your spirit have free flow today, God. We yield our members. We yield our gifts. We yield our talents. We yield our abilities, God. We yield ourselves to you, God. Give ourselves away today, God, to be used by you for your glory, God. In the mighty name of your Son, Jesus. We love you. We thank you. We count it done right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bless your name today. In Jesus' name we say, amen, amen, and amen. Put them hands together and come on, and let the church of God today. He's worthy of the glory, worthy of the praise, worthy of the praise. In Jesus' name.
Do me like Jesus. Thanks, everyone, to stand and give reverence to the reading of God's holy word. We come from 1 Corinthians, 13th chapter, starting at the first verse. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, and I have not charity, I am become as sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith, so that I could remove mountains and have not charity, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned, and have not charity, it profits me nothing. Charity suffereth long time, and is kind. Charity envieth not. Charity abandoneth not itself. It is not puffed up. Doth not behave itself unseemly. Seeketh not her own, is not easily provoked, thinketh no evil, rejoiceth not in iniquity, and rejoiceth in the truth. I read to you 1 Corinthians 13, chapter verses 1 through 6, and let the edifying to your soul.
Amen. And this time we're going to get out of the nebulous moment. The chimes of time ring out the news. Another day is through. Someone slipped and fell. Was that someone you? Your courage to renew. Don't be discouraged. I bring hope to you.
Yeah. Something about that Holy Ghost I can't explain. Something about that Saved and I know that I am. Oh, I'm saved and I know that I am. Well, it's glory, glory. Hallelujah. Saved and I know that I am. Hallelujah, feel that I know that. I sing that song with an understanding this morning. Truly, I'm saved. Ain't nobody got to tell me. I know that I am. I got the evidence. Amen. It's deep down within sight. Ain't nobody got to tell me I got it. I know it. Amen. I'm glad to be here today. Amen. God is good to us. Amen. And we thank God. Amen. It seemed like everybody looked tired, not getting in the service like you should this morning. Amen. I believe in churching. I didn't get up and come out here to look and see what you got on. I think I told you, bro, when you come in, you and your wife look good. Amen. And I'm not worried about what you got on, but we come here to have service today. Amen. 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 We thank God, and we don't want to bring the preacher up and y'all down in the valley somewhere. Amen. But we're going to bring Sister Barefoot up. Amen. I know she's going to try to bring it up before she introduces it, but y'all got to get with her, work with her. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Don't sit here and wait for her to do it for you. You got to get in. You get out what you put in.
Amen.
Don't put nothing in, you don't get nothing out.
Amen.
You got it, sister.
Come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and clap those sanctified hands. Come on and give God some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We still, hallelujah, serve a God who is able to heal all diseases. Hallelujah. Come on, still sitting up high. Hallelujah. Reaching down low. Hallelujah. Oh, come on and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King. Give Him glory, 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 for He is the King. We sing the praises to our King, for He is the King of Kings. We sing the praises.
woke you up this morning, hallelujah. I'm gonna bless his name, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We kept you from angels speaking of King, hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you didn't look out for yourself, hallelujah, he was looking out for you, hallelujah. Oh, God, bless his name, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. This is the place that we call worship. This is the place that we call praise. This is the place that we call Bethel. The place where God lives. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel. The place where God lives. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. This shall be called, yes. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, lay your hands on yourself. This shall be called the place of Bethel. Hallelujah. The place where God rests, rules, and abides. Hallelujah. Come on and touch yourself. Come on, brother, amen. Hallelujah. Enter your spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go and yield your members to him in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. This shall be called the place where you live, God. Hallelujah. Come on and open your mouth and bless the Lord. Come on and stand to your feet and bless the Lord. Hallelujah. As we bring forth, hallelujah, the man of the hour. Hallelujah. Come on and put your hands together for Bishop Bill and Denver. Hallelujah. The barefoot prophet, come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord for you guys. Hallelujah. Come on and preach. Hallelujah. Come on and help me say, preach, preacher. Preach, preacher. Come on and put your hands together. Hallelujah.
Lift your hands and continue a little bit more with that for me. This should be called the house of Bethel. This should be called the house of praise. This should be called the place where God lives. This should be called the house of this should be called
the place of praise.
This should be called
the place of Bethel.
It's the place,
where God
lives. This should be called
the house of worship.
This should be called
the place of praise.
This should be called
The house of worship.
You shall be called.
The place of praise.
You shall be called. Oh, this is the place.
The place
where God lives.
The place where God
lives. This is the place where God lives.
The place
this
where God
lives. Shall be called.
It shall be called.
I have my worship.
The place
of
worship.
It shall be called.
The place of worship.
This is the place where God lives.
Where God
lives. This is the place. This is the place. This is the place. This is the place. This is the place where God lives. I don't know what I'm
going to say.
Where God lives, oh, where God lives, this is the place,
the place where God
lives, this is the place,
the place where God
lives, this is the place, everybody touch yourself, your heart, and your chest, this is the place, this is the
place.
This is the
place.
Shall be called the house of God. I don't know
what it is.
Shall be called his sanctuary. Shall be called the house of prayer.
The place where God.
This should be called the house of
baptism.
This should be.
Not for me to take advantage of it, but he still uses me.
time to reconcile. He still gives. Ain't nobody like you. Nobody like you. Do you wrong and you gonna be mad for a year? Oh, he already know. Don't discriminate. He don't hold grudges. Somebody shout glory. Can't find nobody like him. Nobody like him. Nowhere. Hear in my spirit. Nowhere. Nowhere. You ain't looking for that. Nowhere. You didn't look for that. Nowhere. Nowhere. Nobody like him. Woo! Shabba Boshi. You can give him a worship there. Well, somebody ain't in a worship room. You can give him praise. You can give it to him there. Everybody can worship. I understand that. Praise will sometimes lead over into the atmosphere of worship. And some folks can just jump right into a worship. Because you're there on a daily basis. You're there. With your walk with God, you're there. Somebody shout glory. And it takes nothing for you to get into the presence of God. That's one person in the scripture said, praise is common for the people of God. Amen. You don't have to, amen, stand like you're tired. I've been told you to sit down if you want. Amen. Those of you that desire to stand, you can still with that flow of worship and that presence of the anointing of God, that glory that I feel right now, that I'm in the presence of. Won't allow me to rush my way through this at this moment. Somebody shout glory. But I don't want to tie you out because my spirit is not tired of getting into this presence. Amen. Everybody's not there. But if you will, just give him a wave offering. The old folks used to say, just give him a wave offering. Just give him a wave offering. Everybody don't feel the same way all the time in every service. I know we have our expectations about one particular service to another and how we want it to flow and how we want it to do, how we think we want people to act. But everybody don't feel the same way all the time. And the messenger got to understand that you are on a height because he done dealt with you with the message. All the other folks that you're giving a message to are not really there. Yet they may catch on later and it may have tuned them later. But they ain't where you at right now. So you have to walk yourself through like you're walking newborn babes through until they get in that presence. And once they get there, one person would say, you get to a point in me where you need not man to teach you anymore. Oh, cool shot, have I shared. There's a place of an elevation. And God, that you get, amen, not that you think you know it all and you the big chief and you got all the answers. Not that. It's just that you're in a place with God now where no man really can impart in you anymore. Everything you got now have to come from the anointing, have to come from the Spirit of God, because you're past man's teaching. I can get an argument there, I know, but I ain't got time to mess with you there. Somebody shout glory. Glory. There's just some places, some things that only God can do. And when you walk with him faithfully, he'll take you to that place where nobody can touch you. You hear me, Bishop? Nobody can touch you. They make you preach rains all around you now, but nobody can really touch you with what he has put and planted on the inside of you. Nobody can touch you. Pat your hands one more time, and I believe I'll be able to move on if you have to. If you have to, if you have to. But everything that he does, and every revelation that he grabs into your spirit, man, he desires, no, he demands a praise. You didn't really hit me. Everything, every new information that he taps into your spirit, man, he demands you to stop right there and give him honor for it.
Moses didn't make it in, not because he cussed the people, but because he didn't sanctify God for the miracle he done. Right there, whatever he does, he wants you to give him his due. Touch your neighbor right quick and say, give God what's due to him. And everything else will be all right. Touch the other side of you and say the same thing. Give God what's due to him. Y'all scared of these people today, right? And everything else will be all right. Somebody shout, glory.